Elon Musk just leaked China's new discovery on the far side of the moon. China has announced plans to conduct 3 uncrewed missions in the next 10 years in an effort to compete with the US's lunar presence, according to claims from Chinese official media. This announcement has been triggered by the discovery of a new material on the moon. Due to the presence of helium-3, which has promise as a fuel for nuclear fusion, the substance has the potential to be a source of energy in the future. Substantial amounts of the material were found in samples from China's Chang'e-5 mission, suggesting that they might be extracted from the lunar surface. How feasible is it to be used as a fuel for nuclear fusion? Let's find out while Elon Musk updates us all. Hello everyone, and welcome back to Elon Musk Evolution, where we bring you the most recent news about Elon Musk and his multi-billion-dollar companies, space news, and the latest science and technology. But before we begin, make sure you subscribe to our channel and click the bell icon so you don't miss out on any of our amazing videos. And let's dive right in. China recently hailed the discovery of its first new mineral on the moon and the 6th mineral ever discovered by mankind, making it the 3rd country in the world after the United States and Russia, according to a joint statement from the China National Space Administration and the China Atomic Energy Authority. According to Musk, Changesite Y is a type of colorless, transparent, columnar crystal that was discovered, according to the Chinese news agency Xinhua, through an analysis of lunar basalt particles by a research team from the Beijing Research Institute of Uranium Geology, a division of the China National Nuclear Corporation. Only 1,731 grams, or about 61 ounces, of lunar samples were returned to Earth by the Chang'e-5 mission in 2020. These were the first moon rocks sent back to Earth since 1976. The sample was examined and the International Mineralogical Association verified it as a new mineral. With a radius of around 10 microns, it is a single crystal particle. Changesite Y shares some chemical similarities with the more prevalent phosphate mineral merylite, which has been discovered on Earth as well as in lunar and meteorite samples. The many categories of phosphate minerals are separated. Merylite and whitlockite are two more subgroups of the merylite category. Changesite Y belongs to the bryonite subgroup, which only manifests itself in meteorites and on the moon, claim scientists at BRIUG. With a diameter of only 10 microns, the Changesite Y sample is a single crystalline particle that was painstakingly selected from more than 140,000 other particles of a similar size. Its crystal structure was subsequently determined via X-ray diffraction analysis. With the help of the samples that were returned, scientists were able to determine the first estimates of the helium-3 content in lunar dust, as well as the extraction parameters needed to extract this isotope, Musk stated. Considered to be a viable potential fuel for nuclear fusion, helium-3. It is distinct as the only known stable isotope of any element with more protons than neutrons, having 2 protons and just 1 neutron. Theoretically, a deuterium-helium-3 fusion reaction would release 164.3 megawatt hours of energy per gram of helium-3. More importantly, neither the helium-3 nor its reaction products are radioactive, so they would not cause problems with radioactive nuclear waste disposal like a deuterium-tritium reactor will. However, there are drawbacks, such as the need for helium-3 fusion reactors to run at temperatures far higher than those required for tritium reactors, and the fact that helium-3 is highly uncommon and challenging to isolate on Earth, according to Musk. In fact, the primary method used today to create it is to wait for the tritium in nuclear warheads and related stocks to decay before removing minute amounts of it, amounting to around 15 kilograms or 33 pounds annually. 7.2 parts per trillion is all that naturally exists of it in the Earth's atmosphere. The Earth's mantle contains it as well, but it is generally inaccessible because it is found in primordial gases. However, given that the U.S. has begun employing it in neutron detectors that search for nuclear materials at U.S. border crossings, greatly increasing demand and driving up the price in line, it is unquestionably of tremendous value. Many analysts think it would make a great candidate for mining on the moon because it has recently reached highs of $17,540 US dollars per gram, and demand is only anticipated to increase. Up to 1.1 million metric tons of helium-3 are thought to be present on the moon's surface. According to the International Policy Digest, that amounts to roughly $1.5 quadrillion in resources, and it also presents a transformational fusion energy opportunity, as described by Wu Yang Xian, the head of the Chinese Lunar Exploration Program. Each year, three space shuttle missions could bring enough fuel for all human beings across the world. Obviously, establishing a mining business on the moon would be extremely expensive. It wouldn't be a small operation either, as the highest estimated concentrations of helium-3 in lunar soil are around 50 parts per trillion. China's not released the concentrations it discovered in its samples, which means you'd probably need to process 150 tons of regolith to extract a single gram of this important isotope. Then you would need to transport it back to Earth, which is not an easy or inexpensive task. Furthermore, even though the fusion field has recently seen a lot of energy and activity, it is far from certain that it will become a functioning energy source anytime soon. And if fusion researchers are able to produce and maintain the much higher 600 million degree temperatures required for helium-3 fusion, maybe they will be able to produce and sustain the billion degree temperatures required for hydrogen-boron fusion, which is free from radioactive fuels and byproducts but uses incredibly cheap and abundant fuel. According to fusion company TAE, this process is anticipated to be operational commercially by the early to mid-2030s. However, it is undeniably a concept China wants to investigate, lunar helium mining, Musk stated. A press statement from the China National Nuclear Corporation states that one of this strategic objectives of the country's lunar exploration program is to research nuclear science and analyze the composition of lunar soil and rock samples to assess prospective nuclear energy resources on the moon. The China National Space Administration reported that the next three Phase 4 lunar missions have complete state permission following the announcements of the Change Site Y and Helium-3. According to Shine, Chang'e 6, 7, and 8 will investigate the lunar South Pole and start constructing the foundation for the International Lunar Research Station. They are anticipated to start launching as early as 2024. Professor of Geological Sciences at Brown University James Head asserted that lunar samples are the coin of the realm for comprehending planetary evolution. Scientists are now better able to grasp what produced the moon thanks to the examination of samples that NASA obtained decades ago during the Apollo lunar landing era and later during the lunar robotic landers of the Soviet Union. These discoveries, combined with the outcomes of current computer modeling, according to scientists, provide evidence in favor of the hypothesis that the moon was formed from the fragments of an Earth-Mars impact. The geologic evolution of the moon and its volatile reserves will be better understood because of new samples that have been collected from various parts of the moon, according to a statement from NASA. And according to Professor Head, the near side of the moon's hemisphere facing Earth has been the focus of the majority of sampling up until this point. The moon's uncharted regions are the focus of upcoming expeditions, which includes initiatives by China and the United States. Professor Neal suggested that samples from other geologically fascinating areas, particularly from the planet's younger topography, could contribute in expanding scientists' knowledge of the moon's evolution. And then he continued, "The moon continues to offer some intriguing truths." And that's it for today's video, guys. Thank you so much for watching. We sincerely hope you enjoyed it. And if you did, please click on the like button and make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel for more. And we'll see you next time.